Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. You clicked on a really fun video today. So before we get into all of that, which is so exciting, I wanted to remind you guys, if you have not entered my giveaway, I will link that in the cards above right here. I am giving away a Christmas-themed spirit jersey. So it's a really good one. So it's running until Thanksgiving Day. So make sure that you run and go put your entry in. So there's still a few more days to enter. And I will announce the winner on Thanksgiving Day in the description box of that video. So make sure to head back to that video to check it out once the giveaway has closed. So on to today's video. I am announcing a Disney trip. I have kept this trip secret since February. It has been so long and I've wanted to wait to share it until it got a little bit closer. So by the time this video goes up, it will be 38 days away. So I can't believe I'm getting to talk about this. I'm like, oh, I've been holding on to this for so long. So we are going for New Year's Eve. Oh my word, I'm so excited for this. I've never been to Disney on New Year's Eve. This will either be the craziest trip we've ever done or the best trip we've ever done. So we will be there from December 28th through January 1st. So we'll be there for 4 nights and 5 days and we are going with my husband's family. So it'll be me and Andy, his parents and his sister. So it'll be the 5 of us and we are staying off property this trip. So it's like, oh my gosh, I know, who am I? I always rent points. But we are staying off property this trip. We're staying at a Disney Springs resort. So it's gonna feel like we're on property just because we're right across the street from Disney Springs. We'll be super close to everything still, but we will be at the Wyndham Bonnet Creek and I have stayed there several times. So whenever we do stay off property, we stay at Bonnet Creek. We love it. It's just our go-to, we love it. So we are getting a 2-bedroom condo so that all of us can stay together. And that was just kind of the best deal for us that week, especially that time of year. So I'm really excited to share my itinerary about this trip. I love watching these kind of videos. So I figured it would be fun to kind of share with you what we're doing on this trip. So obviously I don't have like an hour by hour play by play of, you know, our plan or anything like that. We're still wanting to keep it flexible and, you know, not try to cram too much in. So I do have our dining reservations and I don't have our fast passes yet because we haven't hit that 30-day mark because we're staying off property. We have to wait. So we'll see what's left at 30 days out. I'm kind of just praying that at least something is available. So I've yet to plan out that, but I do have kind of our time mapped out at least and our dining reservations. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So we are leaving early, early, early on the 28th and we should land in MCO around 10 a.m.-ish. And we are gonna be getting a rental car and we're gonna head straight to Hollywood Studios. So we are jumping right into our day. We didn't wanna waste a moment. And yeah, so we're gonna head straight there and I don't have lunch planned. We'll probably just do something quick service just because I didn't want us to feel rushed or stressed out in case, you know, things took a little longer at baggage claim or, you know, trying to get the car, if there's traffic, just you never know what can happen. So we don't have any lunch reservations, so that'll be nice. So we'll probably just do Woody's Lunchbox or something like that once we get to Hollywood Studios. So we're gonna spend the day there. And then for dinner, I am really excited about this one. We are going to Jiko at Animal Kingdom Lodge. And that was the one restaurant that we didn't get to try when we stayed at Animal Kingdom Lodge in September. So I'm so excited to go back, especially with all the Christmas decorations being up. It's just gonna be the most magical time of year. So we're gonna check out Jiko that night and then we'll head back and check in at our resort and kind of call it a night. So the next day on the 29th is our Epcot day and I'm really excited to check out Festival of the Holidays and we're gonna kind of do that for our lunch. We'll do kind of an eat around the world kind of thing with his family. I thought that would be something really fun to do. And we'll spend the day there and then we have dinner at La Hacienda. So I'm trying, and I'm hoping that the timing works out to where we can get a window table to watch Illuminations with the holiday finale. So that's what we'll do for dinner that night. And then on the 30th, the next day, we're gonna do Magic Kingdom. So we're having that be our only Magic Kingdom day for the reason of the 31st is insane. Magic Kingdom, if you've ever been on New Year's Eve, if you've even heard about it, you probably know that it typically hits park capacity mid-morning, and they'll do different levels of closure. Only certain limitations with people's tickets and reservations are allowed in, and it varies every year. Sometimes they'll reopen the park in the evening. There's been some years that it hasn't hit park capacity. You just never know. So we're gonna play it safe and not do Magic Kingdom on New Year's Eve, but we are gonna be doing it on the 30th because they do a dress rehearsal of the New Year's Eve fireworks on the 30th. They have a show at 6:30 and at 11:40. So we're gonna probably do the 6:30 one, and we have dinner at Whispering Canyon Cafe at Wilderness Lodge. So, oh, I forgot to mention, we are gonna try to visit all of the deluxe resorts to see their Christmas decorations. So that is our goal. I think we have it mapped out to where we'll see everything, with the exception of Old Key West and Saratoga. But other than those, I think we'll get to see every deluxe resort. So I'm really excited about that. So that's what we're doing for our Magic Kingdom day. And then kind of depending on how the day goes, we might go back and spend the rest of the night at Magic Kingdom after dinner, or we may head back to the resort. I don't know, we'll just kind of play that by ear. So that's the kind of stuff that I'm not really planning out. We'll just kind of see how we feel. So on the 1st, no, sorry, we're not on the 1st, the 31st, on New Year's Eve, this is the day we had gone back and forth about. Do we do a park? Do we just have this be a resort hopping day? And I think the consensus was with our group was that we're not gonna do a park on New Year's Eve. And I think if it were just me, I would probably go to Epcot on New Year's Eve, but because we are traveling with 5 people, you know, I just think it's gonna cater to everybody best if we don't do a park on New Year's Eve. So that's what we've decided to do. So I've made lunch reservations at the Grand Floridian Cafe, and that'll be fun because then we can do kind of a monorail loop tour and check out all of those resorts, see the gingerbread house, and you know, that'll be really, really fun. So we'll spend the afternoon there, and then we might go check out some of the moderate resorts and see their Christmas decorations. You know, again, we'll just play it by ear and see how it goes. And then for dinner that night, I've made reservations at the Yachtsman Steakhouse at the Yacht Club. So our reservations there are around, I think, 8:30 or 8:45, I can't remember. And so we'll get into the Yacht Club, and then after we're done at dinner there, we're gonna walk over to the boardwalk and kind of do our New Year's Eve celebration on the boardwalk. And hopefully we'll be able to see some of the fireworks from Epcot at the boardwalk. So that'll be what we're doing to celebrate New Year's Eve. And I thought that would just be a really fun alternative to being in the parks. The boardwalk may be packed, but I think it'll still be really fun. And again, a great alternative to being in the parks. So that is what we're doing for New Year's Eve. And then on the 1st, this is the day we are checking out of our resort and we're gonna head to Disney Springs. So that is what we're doing on the 1st, and we'll kind of check out some of the shops. And I don't know if everything will be open or not. I think it will be. But even if it's not, we have lunch reservations at Homecoming. So at Chef Art's Homecoming. And we'll do that kind of an early lunch time frame and just kind of explore Disney Springs. And they'll probably still have all of their Christmas stuff up, so that'll be fun to see it there. And then we fly home. So that is our Disney trip for New Year's Eve. And I'm really excited about this. I've been waiting to post this announcement video because I have several like holiday themed, New Year's Eve themed videos that I really wanna do. So I thought it would make more sense to post this video first so that you guys would know why I'm talking about this so much. So that is our trip. I'm really excited to vlog this trip. I feel like now that I have one trip kind of under my belt, I know what to improve on. I know what I would do differently this go around. And I think it'll be really, really fun. And I'm really excited for these videos. Anyway, follow along. Again, make sure you're subscribed so that you don't miss these vlogs. And I'm really, really excited for what's coming up on my channel. I have a bunch of fun ideas. So thank you guys so much for joining. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your support. I'm just, again, so excited. I know I keep saying that. I'm so excited, but I really, really am. And I think that's it for today. So thank you guys again, and I'll see you next time. Bye.